you all to raise as we look to start the ceremony on a good note with a Tamil Thai Vaazhthu.
Lucky are those who have something that makes goodbye so hard. APOVTC19 is the first of its kind in the history of our college. It is conducted to commemorate the successful conclusion of one of the many chapters in the book of life of our graduates.
Government Villupuram Medical College and Hospital, our proud college with a 10-year legacy, has made many humane doctors. We have overlooked Troisians, Zenforianz and Feroxians, making it through successfully. Now, it's time for the batch of 2K13 Zenforianz to step into the next phase of life.
The batch, loved by all, and have brought many historic changes to our college. Zenforianz, born to heal, the trendsetters of GVMC. Let us take a look at the memories of the Zen Squad. It was a wonderful trip down memory lane for the batch of Zenforianz.
With courage, you'll dare to take risks. Have the strength to be compassionate and the wisdom to be humble. courage is the foundation of integrity. Here we have amongst us people of immense courage, overflowing compassion and inspiring humility. Words cannot define our elation in having them with us on this day where the future shines bright and the youth stand with their hands held high. We request our dignitaries, respected Dean Dr. Shankaranarayanan sir, chief guest Mr. Satish Babu sir, Dr. Jayachandran sir, Dr. K. Muniyappan sir, Dr. A.S. Rajendran sir, medical superintendent sir, vice principal ma'am, our deputy superintendents and our resident medical officer sir, to grace the dais with their enigmatic presence. Light gives of itself freely, filling all available space. It gives of itself and is not thereby diminished. Live in rooms full of light. We are each gifted in a unique and important way. It is our privilege and our adventure to discover our own special light. We request our dignitaries to lighten the ceremonial lamp.
Thank you, dignitaries. Age cannot wither, nor custom stale. Her infinite variety describes our vice principal, Dr. Chandra Madam, the best way. Clad with elegance and benevolence, she is an astute and an agile mentor, going with grace, that extra little mile to equip the students with the colossal intent of ensuring a healthy society. Ma'am, I request you to welcome the gathering.
A pleasant, colorful evening to one and all present here. On behalf of Government Villupuram Medical College, I deem it a great pleasure to welcome our entire GVMC family for the graduation ceremony. First and foremost, it's my esteemed honor to welcome our beloved Dean, Dr. G. Shankaranarayanan, a great person who has changed the entire campus of GVMC and hospital into a clean, green environment. He has uplifted the college to great heights. Next, I would like to welcome our chief guest, Mr. Satish Babu, Chief General Surge Manager, HR, NLC, for spending his much valuable time in this function. Then I have great pleasure in welcoming our Professor, Dr. K. Jayachandran, retired Professor of Pediatric Surgery, who is well known for his professional supremacy. I am very much pleased to welcome our ex-dean, Professor Muniyappan, Professor A.S. Rajendran sir, for gracing the occasion. I welcome our MS Dr. Arivaragan sir, RMO Dr. Kadir sir, Deputy Superintendent Dr. Bugalendi and Dr. Padmanabhan sir. I welcome all the faculty who is present here. It is a great moment to welcome our proud parents. Last but not the least, my dear students who had been the pillar of GVMC success. I welcome each and everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Gratitude becomes love. Love becomes devotion. Devotion becomes surrender. Surrender becomes faith. And faith reveals the divine. We request the representatives of the Zenforian batch to felicitate our beloved dean. We request our dean to felicitate our chief guest, Mr. Sadish Babu, sir. We request our dean to felicitate Dr. Jayachandran, sir. Request our dean to felicitate Dr. Muniyappan, sir. We Zenforians take this stage a chance to express our gratitude towards our beloved professors who had their superannuation the previous year. We request our dean to felicitate Dr. A.S. Rajendran, sir. Graduation day brings with it a roller coaster of emotions for grads and their families alike. Now it's a time of celebration and achievement. There is reflection on past trials and successes, as well as hope for the future. We call upon Dr. Karthik of the Zenforian batch to share a few words with us.
Respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, a very pleasant evening to my dear parents and my very dear batchmates, Zenforians 13. A much awaited and most memorable day in my life is this day. I first of all want to thank our respected Dean Sir for his permission to conduct this event in such a grand manner. So from where we started to where we stand, this is what GVMC provided us. This night may be the last night in this college, but the experience what we gained will travel throughout our life. In such a way, I want to express my old memories when I come here 6 years back, where I was like a kangaroo in his mother's pouch. Now I'm standing before you giving this speech. This is a great development what I had in this college. I was excited before coming in this profession because we had many opportunities in other fields, but the reason I selected this is because it's my aim. So I was very excited but also a little scared of this profession, of this college and provided of my seniors. So, but to my reality, what I'm standing here is what I am now. So I'll proudly say I'm a proud GVMCN. The life that many of others outside the compound still dream of. From the first day I entered the anatomy department, in which the smell of formalin was the smell of medicine. And the way our body works in physiology was an interesting one. And knowing about the organisms which lived a million years ago, where we don't even exist, about microbes, knowing even paracetamol as toxicity, knowing our dead bodies can talk more than when we are alive, knowing all the medicine books are written by only sons, but only one book which was written by a father, Alagappan, which made me pass in the exam, knowing where to tie knots, where not to, knowing I was born with a route which had many stops and breaks, but was helped by a man who was once standing here like this, a physician. Knowing about a baby before you're becoming as a daddy was a great deal. So with a weight hearted, I sum up my experience. I thank all the dignitaries, all my parents, all my batchmates, my seniors and juniors for making this event a great successful one. And finally, I would like to say, we should always follow 4 P's. Respect your profession, respect your parents, respect your patients, and at last, don't forget to respect your personal life. Thank you.
We now have the representatives of the Bad Zenforians, Dr. Ajit Kumar and Dr. Aruna Devi, to reminisce their hassles and tassels through 5 years of medical school. Both of them are as beautiful as the leaves and as bold as the branches, as beautiful as the sunset and as bold as the sun. In short, they are bold and beautiful.
Our most esteemed dignitaries, teachers, dear parents, beloved friends, dear juniors, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you all. It is a great privilege for us by standing in front of you on behalf of our batch to express the happiness that we feel in our hearts today. People only remember the first and forget the rest, but I believe that these 5.5 years with you all have a journey and we will take many memories together.
We don't need an award or a medal just to prove that we have talent within us. All of us are blessed with some talents. So that we are here in this day. I have never thought that this day will be such special to me this day.
5.5 years, my dear batchmates, let me remind you, it took all these 5.5 years to get this degree for which we have been working so hard.
We need to retain the things that we learned other than the academic things. Like, we have to appreciate the others, we have to respect others, we have to gain the courage. These are called the lessons of life. This will help us to go through the next stage of our life.
Of course, we solve problems by ourselves, answer our tests individually, go through our lives on our own. But one cannot deny how important the people are. Our parents, friends, teachers and administrators. Especially God made it possible to see through all the challenges, comes out of them stronger and better. For all these blessings, I along with the entire batch feel grateful today.
Once again, we can congratulate ourselves by a huge class of applause. Now, I call upon Dr. Naveen sir to disclose about our alumni association.
A splendid good evening to one and all here. Respected members on the dais, and as everyone knows here, beloved Dean has given me this esteemed privilege to be here standing in front of you to talk about something which we, the last three batches, have never thought of. So it gives me immense pleasure to stand before you all on this wonderful evening, and the stars of the show, Zenforianz, my beloved juniors, seriously, and their proud parents, nothing gives me more joy and happiness when you invited me to come here. Thank you very much for that, first of all. So this apotheosity, I think that word itself is a little bit of difficult to pronounce. And when I saw the video on Facebook for the first time, I was quite impressed. Kudos to you guys. I want to say something. Today, while driving into the college, first of all, I could see perfectly laid roads, fully raised compounds, and a trauma block under halfway construction, and a beautiful majestic arch, thanks to your beloved Dean. But the reality when we Trojans 2010 batch walked in was totally different. You guys can't even imagine it. Guys, it was, you know, mud paths, completely mud paths, and buildings which are under constructions, new hostels, and eyes with tons and tons of hopes. Guys, the hopes was which only visible to us. And when I see my dear juniors enjoying all this stuff, this is delightful. Trust me, I am delighted here. Amidst all this, when each batch went out of this college, be it Trojans, Xavians, and Ferroxians, everybody took thousands and thousands of memories with them, but had only one small little expectation. Can we go back in time? Don't you guys have it? Don't you guys want to start when you came inside this college and your seniors helped you come out and you had thousands and thousands of dreams how you are going to survive these 5.5 years? Do you want to go back in time? Yes, and that's why I'm here today to announce officially the formation of an alumni association for Government Villupuram Medical College and Hospital to help you relive memories and create beautiful moments even after leaving this extraordinary place, but also to help our budding juniors and our college department in whichever way we can. I would like to let you know that this is the first step which you are taking towards a very big dream. I request every single student of this association to participate equally and in both ways of physical, mental, and financial too. Because an association has everything, right? So with four of my batch members as secretaries in this initial phase, Dr. Manigandan, Dr. Joshua, Dr. Ramya, and Dr. Shanmugapriya, and at a responsible, very big responsible position as president, let's put our hands together to nurture and raise this association. Thanks to everyone for giving me this chance here. Thank you.
We now have the girls of our college on stage to welcome you all again with a graceful performance.
Tadrum namta drum ta dhalam kutak dekura de ta gira 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 drum tak drum drum ta kitata da ta jam kitata jam ta ta tanam ta ta tarum ta ta kitata da ta kitata da kitata da ta ritata dana tata runa tata dana tata da jam ta tanam ta tarum ta gadim ta kitata da angira da kitata da dim ta tarigata da ta jam dim da ta ta jam nam da ta ta jam tam ta kitata dana ta da angira da kitata da dim ta tarigata da ta jam dim dak takita jom jom dakita dak jom da jom jom dakita ta jom kida dak 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 ta jom ta nista ta tarista ta ta dana nista ta tarista ta dakita dak dak nista ta dana ta ta jom tarista dana ta ta kida dak 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 ta
Thank you.
Mr. Singaram, our academic officer.
அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். இந்த இனிய நன்னாளில் மாணவ செல்வங்களாகிய மருத்துவ மாணவ செல்வங்களாகிய உங்களுக்கும் உங்களை பெற்றெடுத்த பெற்றோர்களுக்கும் அதேபோல் உங்களுக்கு போதித்த ஆசிரிய பெருமக்கள் பேராசிரிய பெருமக்களுக்கும் இந்த நிகழ்ச்சியில் கலந்து கொண்டிருக்கக்கூடிய அனைவருக்கும் என்னுடைய மாலை வணக்கத்தை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். இந்த மருத்துவ படிப்பு என்பது எல்லாருக்குமே கிடைக்காது. இது யாருக்கு அந்த மருத்துவம் கிடைக்க வேண்டும், யார் படித்தால் மக்களுக்கு சேவை செய்வார்கள் என்பதை சரியாக உணர்ந்துதான் உங்களை போன்ற மாணவ செல்வங்களுக்கு இந்த இது வாய்ப்புகள் கிடைத்திருக்கிறது. எனவே இது சாதாரண படிப்பல்ல. நீங்கள் உண்மையிலேயே அதில் இந்த விழுப்புரம் அரசு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரியில் வந்து நீங்கள் படிச்சிருக்கீங்க பார்த்தீங்களா, அது இதை விட மிகப்பெரிய கொடுத்து வச்சவங்க நீங்கள் எல்லாமே. இங்கே இருக்கக்கூடிய பேராசிரிய பெருமக்கள், இங்கே வரக்கூடிய முதல்வர்கள், நம்முடைய விபி மேடம் அவர்கள் சொல்லும்போது சொன்னாங்க, இந்த மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி மருத்துவமனைக்கு வந்திருக்கக்கூடிய நம்முடைய முதல்வர்கள் அவர்கள் அவருடைய சொந்த இன்ட்ரெஸ்டோட இந்த மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி மருத்துவமனை வளாகம் தூய்மையாக இருக்க வேண்டும் என்று சொல்லி இரவு பகல் பாராமல், நீங்கள் நேற்று நைட்லாம் 10:30 வரையிலாம் வீட்டுக்கு போகாமையே இருந்து இந்த கிரவுண்ட்லாம் சுத்தம் பண்ணணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு எல்லாத்தையும் மிகச்சிறப்பாக செய்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். இது மட்டுமல்ல, இந்த பகுதியிலே பிற்படுத்தப்பட்ட இந்த மாவட்டத்தில் மருத்துவம் எல்லா ஏழை எளிய மக்களுக்கும் கிடைக்க வேண்டும் என்பதை தன்னுடைய மனதிலே வைத்து கொண்டு இரவு பகலாக இந்த மருத்துவமனையை ஒரு சிறந்த மருத்துவமனை, ஒரு தனியாருக்கு இணையான மருத்துவமனையாக கொண்டு வருவதற்கு தன்னால் என்ன முயற்சிகளை செய்ய வேண்டுமோ அனைத்தும் செய்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். அப்படிப்பட்ட ஒரு நல்ல முதல்வர் நமக்கு கிடைத்திருக்கிறார்கள், அதே மாதிரி துணை முதல்வர் கிடைத்திருக்கிறார்கள். இங்கே பேராசிரிய பெருமக்கள் அத்துணை பெருமை உங்களுக்கு எல்லாம் உங்களுடைய நலநிலை அக்கறையிலே நிறைய பங்கெடுத்து கொண்டு சிறப்பாக இங்கே கல்வி கற்றுக் கொடுத்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். இது அது இந்த விழுப்புரம் அரசு மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி மருத்துவமனைக்கு நீங்கள் வந்தது உண்மையிலேயே இறைவன் கொடுத்த வரம் என்று தான் நான் சொல்ல முடியும். ஒரு இந்த ஒரு நல்ல அருமையான தரமான மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி நீங்கள் படிச்சிருக்கிறீங்க. நீங்கள் இந்த படித்தது மட்டுமல்ல, நீங்கள் படித்த இந்த கல்லூரி உங்களை பெற்றெடுத்த பெற்றோர்கள் இவர்களெல்லாம் போற்றும் வகையிலே நீங்கள் அனைவரும் ஒற்றுமையாக நல்ல திறமையாக இருந்து இன்னும் இதோடு மட்டுமல்ல நீங்கள் வந்து இன்னும் முதுகலை படிக்க வேண்டும், சிறப்பாக படித்து நாட்டு மக்களுக்கு நல்ல சேவை செய்து உங்கள் பெற்றோருக்கும் நீங்கள் படித்த கல்லூரிகளுக்கும் உங்களுடைய உங்களுக்கு பள்ளி சொல்லிக் கொடுத்த ஆசிரிய பெருமக்களுக்கும் பெருமை சேர்க்க வேண்டும் என்று சொல்லி இந்த நேரத்திலே சொல்லிக்கொள்ள கடமைப்பட்டிருக்கின்றேன். அதேபோல் நீங்கள் அனைவருமே சிறப்பாக உங்களுடைய மனதிலே உறுதியோடு இருந்தால் எல்லாமே கிடைக்கும். எப்படி என்று சொன்னால், புன்னகைத்து பாருங்கள், நட்புகள் கிடைக்கும். மனித நேயம் இருந்தால் நல்ல மனம் கிடைக்கும். நம்பிக்கை வையுங்கள், வெற்றி கிடைக்கும். உண்மையாய் உறுதியோடு உழைத்து பாருங்கள், வாழ்க்கையில் எல்லாமே வெற்றி வெற்றி வெற்றியாய் கிடைக்கும் என்று சொல்லி நீங்கள் அனைவருமே வாழ்க்கையில் இன்னும் மேலும் பல பதவிகளை பல படிப்புகளை படித்து சிறப்பாக வாழ வேண்டும் என்று சொல்லி இந்த நேரத்திலே வாய்ப்பளித்த அத்துணை நல்ல உள்ளங்களுக்கும் எனது நன்றியினை தெரிவித்து விடைபெறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
தேங்க்யூ சார். உவமைகளின் சுரங்கமே, உண்மையின் உருவமே, தேன்மலை சாரலே, கலகலகப்பின் கூடாரமே, நகைச்சுவையின் நிறைகுடமே, உணர்ச்சிகளின் கண்ணாடியே, பேதங்கள் காணா உயர் மனதே, எளிமையாயிருந்து மனிதநேயத்தோடு மனிதனாய் வாழ்பவரே, எங்களின் இரத்தினமே, கல்லூரியின் முதல்வரே, உம்மை வணங்கி மகிழ்கிறோம். பேஷன் ஃபார் சர்வீசஸ் that precipitates into a resplendable concern for humanity, conceived with an insatiable thirst for the society's health. The corridors of the wonderful enclave of learning proclaims the wisdom, intellect and prowess of its treasure, our beloved Dean, Professor Dr. Shankar Narayanan sir. Stretching his skills through the channels of his trust, he transports a heritage in the medical arena. On an endeavor to dispense and dissipate the artistry thus garnered in this adobe of learning, the contribution of our dean is our favorite success tale. I laden with ecstasy in requesting him to deliver the presidential address.
Before the presidential address, I will first would like to hear the felicitation address by our former dean, Professor Dr. Muniyappan.
Respected our beloved dean, Professor Dr. G. Shankaranarayanan, the dean of our institution, and also the eminent ENT surgeon in the city of Chennai, respected our chief guest, general manager HR NLC, and my dear Zenforianz 13, and also the respected parents, மதிப்பிற்குரிய எங்கள் இளங் டாக்டர்களுடைய பெற்றோர்கள் அனைவருக்கும் என்னுடைய மனமார்ந்த வாழ்த்துக்களை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். Because this is the Zenforianz 13th day, it will be memorable throughout your life career. Respected Professor Jayachandran, respected our Professor A.S. Rajendran, respected Dr. E.S. Harivalagan, medical superintendent, respected Dr. Chandra, vice principal, respected Dr. Pugalendi, Dr. K.R. Padmanabhan, deputy superintendent, respected Dr. Kadir, residential medical officer, respected professors, assistant professors, S.R. J.R. and the students of our government Villupuram Medical College, dear non-teaching members, and my dear admin personnels of our institution, I am very proud to participate in this wonderful function. I am seeing the caps on your head for the convocation ceremony. I am seeing the, even though it is meant for graduation ceremony, I can see the more responsibility on your head. I can see the young budding doctors have to achieve so many things in the state, country, and all over the world. It is your duty to deliver your service, utilize your knowledge to cure the disease for the patients till your last breath. It is very respectable profession, very responsible profession. It is your duty to utilize the knowledge wherever you are going, and you deliver the knowledge for the patients. You have to realize the, you have to feel the pain of the patients. You have to self-realize the patient's sorrow, pain. But you have to see them as your relatives, not as only patients. Then only you can feel the pain of the patients. You have to consider them as your father, mother, brothers, sisters, and your children, like that. Then only you can have involvement in the field of medicine. Thought of role is waiting for you to find a solution for the disease which you are not able to solve by your senior medical fraternity. That's why I can see the responsibility on your head. I am advising you to take care of your parents. You have to fulfill their dream. What are all the expectations from your parents? What are all the needs of your parents? You have to do. Then you have to maintain the dignity of the profession. Time is very, very important. When you are treating the patient, in time, not after expiring the time. You have to approach the patient in a kind manner. You have to spend time to their sorrows and grievances, not only the disease and also their mind. That is the very, very important the publics are expecting from the doctors. I feel proud to be part of this institution once, even though I am nearby Sri Venkateswara Medical College, Pandi. I have an eye on this institution. Anything we want to deliver the service to the institution for the development. I used to receive the patients from Government Villupuram Medical College. I used to teach them angiography, angioplasty, even sometimes MRI, CT scan in Venkateswara Medical College Hospital on free of cost. 10% free for the patient referred from Villupuram Medical College Hospital. For that, I requested my chairman to give free hand to treat the people coming from the village. I am also brought up from a village and agriculture family. That's why I have some soft corner on our people coming from village area. For your information, I sent 300 places from our hospital buses on free of cost. 50% free of treatment. For that, I am getting so many patients from this area. And also I sponsored my postgraduate, MS postgraduate students recently, two postgraduate students for special posting here till the PG postgraduate students are coming now. I am congratulating our beloved Dean for getting 40 PG seat for our institution. Really, our Dean is lucky person to receive 40 seats of postgraduate, highest in this level of our institution in Tamil Nadu. Credit goes to our beloved, respected Dean. And also, I have to thankful to all the deans who worked here to upliftment of our institution. My dear budding doctor, don't forget this institution. Wherever you are going, throughout the world or throughout the country, it is your mother's land like. You have to do your service to develop this institution in future, wherever you are working. I hope that you will be the best doctor on the in the country in your future. You have to do achievements. You have to create new history in the field of medicine. I hope, wish you all the best. You will be very best doctor in this country, in the state, in future. I hope, and also congratulating your parents once again. Thank you very much for this opportunity given to me.
Thank you, sir. Dear audience, for your notice, Dr. K. Muniyappan, sir, is an outstanding scholar. He has a service record of 20 years in Stanley Medical College and 3 years in Madras Medical College as the professor of surgery. He has served as the dean for 3 medical colleges across the state. Theni Medical College, Shivagangai Medical College, and our very own Villupuram Medical College. Currently, he is rendering his services in Sri Venkateshwara Medical College. He has been bestowed with international, national, and state awards, summing up to 7, for his public service, academic activities, and his innumerable achievements in the field of surgery, including Bharat Jyoti Award, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Award, Best Citizen of India Award. Thank you, sir, for your gracious present.
Respected Dean, respected former Dean, Professor Muniyappan sir, and respected other honorable delegates and my colleagues in the stage of Medical Superintendent, RMO, and Vice Principal, Madam. First of all, I am very thankful to this batch to inviting me and remembering me as one among the other professors, and thankful to our Dean. I am moving about from house. At the time, call is coming from Mr. Karthik and our Dean. I am very happy to be here in this occasion. I am first of all congratulating our students for their hard work coming from 2013 till date to become a doctor, to get a graduation. And our parents, you don't forget your parents. They are the pillars, they are root, they are all this way, they are coming along with you. Financially, mentally, morally, supporting to bring this level and made you in a respectable position. It is up to their day. That's all. After that, your responsibility starts in the form of further improving your knowledge, what you have learned so far. Don't bother about the first year, second year, third year, fourth year. All the knowledge always coming along with you till the end of your profession. Don't forget it. And don't hesitate to refer the book. Don't hesitate to your problem with your higher peoples and professors and other colleagues, because everybody have a lacunae. The medical field is ocean. You can't swim. It's not possible to swim till the end of your death, any profession. Nowadays, micro level development is there. Retinologists and knee surgeons alone, and cardiologists, the electrophysiologists. Like that, about 60 to imagine. When I am entering in the Villupuram as a primary health center doctor, only about 4 MDs available in the Villupuram. Now it is about 50 MDs. That means the number of the faculties is more, and want of service is more, and still, because of people having economical uplift of your development of the country, they can able to get all these facilities from the medical field. So, because I am learned from lot of things, PGC level, taluk level, district level, finally I am having opportunity. First of all, I am thankful to government and thankful to God to entering this prestigious medical college 2010 to 2018 and retired in front of that to our prestigious and honorable Dean, Professor G. Sangaranarayanan. So all this way I made out is only 2 points. Don't bother about the sex, don't bother about the age, don't bother about the race, don't bother about the religions. Your aim is only over the disease, only the relieving the agony of the patient, nothing else. The money is there, matter, I understand. It is also needed for your life, automatically come. Once you are concentrated over the patient, automatically come in your way. Whatever you want, you can get it. One thing you should not forget it. You are always not living for the money. Money also is important. Another one I want to, in this stage, I want to inform you. Before you are going to the next stage, you sit in your own place and decide which specialty you must take it. Which one is best suitable for you. If you have doubt, you mingled with our professors, our senior people, and choose the one good profession and go ahead. Another one request is, in among the other peoples, whoever want to go for PG is no problem. At the same time, our village people need lot of MBBS. Because they, all the quacks, all these peoples are infiltrated into the village and they are doing abnormal investigations, abnormal treatment, and made the patient become very serious, then sent to the higher level center where these the problems are there in the treatment. So in this way, don't bother about you are having MBBS. Still you have chance to be there who work in the village level for at least few years. In this setup, you sit down and decide it and work about few years. Then you go to the next level so that you know what is the problem happening in your places, villages, and district level and country level, so that you can choose your field. This field is suitable for me. This field is good for me, like that. So with this few advice, I have a right to advise, because we are coming through all the pathway. We have not guided by any persons. We are coming with our own pathway. We don't know. We should contact with all the higher peoples. We are gone with your own way. We are come up. If you are having this, all this connection with and senior people and professor, you will come up like anything. Once again, my heartfelt congratulations for this batch and all this affection over me, and very thankful to you and your parents and other dignitaries. Thank you.
Eloquence and elegance, charm and charisma, brainy and bright, a few qualities to describe our beloved Dean, Professor Dr. G. Shankar Narayanan, sir. Sir, please deliver the presidential address.
It will also be a welcome address, don't worry. Good evening, dear friends. Few days back, the representatives of this batch met me. So they wanted to do this function in a unique and grand manner. And so it happens. Today we are all here. So at that time, we were thinking about the guests who are to be invited for this function. This is a very solemn occasion for these 100-odd students, not only for them, for their parents. So when we were shortlisting the names for the guests to be invited, due to the election restrictions, we had some problem in getting our own university or administrative heads. So at that juncture, we thought of getting a person from our neighboring plays a big public sector undertaking, Neyveli Lignite Corporation, and we contacted them, and now we have here Mr. Satish Babu, who is gracing us with his presence. I welcome you, sir. Thank you, sir. He is a eminent person who is a MBA with a social work MSW background, and he is a HR person, so he is going to be a good choice today for being the chief guest. Then we wanted a sort of a unconventional person to come here, a unique personality. We might see a good doctor. You might be a good surgeon, pediatric surgeon or any surgeon. You might be a great musician. You might have so many qualities. But the rare feature of a humane personality. In that background, we now have Dr. Jayachandran, a very great personality who has been a former professor of pediatric surgery, who has worked in Stanley, at Chengalpet, at Madurai, different places, and the feedback across the borders from all the districts, the whole set of his people who have come in contact with him say that he's a role model, he's a leader, he's a guru for them. So then I thought he is the correct person to come here and give you the convocation address. Welcome you, sir. Thank you, sir. So then we also have our former Dean Muniyappan, who has given a very good speech. So I will not take much of your time because you have heard me a lot of times and you still have down the line a lot of other people are going to address you. So I will try to make my speech a very short one. I also thank the team here, my administrative team, who have been helping me in all the activities that is taking place. I welcome and thank the press people. The press people have also honored us by coming today. So as the head of this institution, it is my duty to tell what the government expects of a doctor who is graduating, an Indian medical graduate who has finished his graduation. When I was a student as an MBBS, when I finished, at that time the goal was health for all by 2000. But still, have we achieved health for all? Means, to a great extent we have achieved. Lot of goals have been achieved. But still, there is a big gap. So the government expects that the Indian medical graduate should have an adequate skill, knowledge, communication and responsiveness, and he should be a person of responsibility, and he should be a first contact physician for the community. That is what the government is expecting from you. And that too at a benchmark which is to exceed the international standards. So all along till now, you have all been in a very controlled environment. Now you have finished your graduation. You are going to go to your own place or some other place where you might have not a controlled environment. So today is a sort of an example. We were all here. We were all trying to light the kutuvilakku. You were all observing. We were not able to properly light it. Because this is not a controlled environment. You have a lot of breeze, so many other things are there. So the life is going to be like that. All along you were in a controlled environment where many things were already decided. There are many, many people guarding you. But those barriers are all going to be broken. You're all going to be fed into a society where the demands are more. But you will always be protected and guarded by our profession. Still our profession commands respect. So that will be there guarding you. But be ready to accept your responsibility as a full-fledged medical graduate. At this juncture, I would first offer my salutations to the parents, the proud parents who have done a lot of sacrifice, lot of commitment, lot of motivation. I'm sure they would have undergone a lot of sacrifice before making you a doctor. So my salutations to the proud parents, my congratulations and blessings to the budding young doctors. So when I stand here today, in a way it is also graduation for me, in the sense it is almost 1 year since I have come here. So in this 1 year's time, so the first function when I came here was the graduation ceremony of the previous batch. I don't know how many of you were there on that day. I said I will try to do some changes to this place. That is the reason I am coming here to Villupuram. And I think I have reasonably performed to bring about some sort of a change to this campus. I was able to do it not because of the position that I hold, but it is because of the love and affection of the people around me. So that is the message. You can earn money. Money is not a big problem. It's very difficult to earn people. The love is going to be the greatest thing that is going to be with you throughout your life. Thank you. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, sir. We request our Deputy Superintendent, Dr. Pugalendi, sir, to introduce our chief guest, Mr. Sadish Babu, sir, Chief General Manager of NLC.
Good evening, everybody. I feel privileged in introducing our chief guest, Mr. Sadish Babu. He did his MBA from Madurai Kamarajar University and his Master of Social Work in Loyola College, the prestigious college. He holds position in Chief General Manager in Human Resources and also the past Secretary of National Institute of Personnel Management. He has a large experience of 30 years in human resources management, industrial relations, training and development in the Chennai Port Trust, Hindustan Latex and also Navy Lignite Corporation. He is a life member in the National Institute of Personnel Management and also in the training and development. At current assignment is functioning as a group head in human resources, responsible for the recruitment, policy, manpower at corporate level, group head of learning and development center in Navy Lignite Corporation. He has visited many countries like Italy, France, Germany, Switzerland, Sweden, and being a resource person. I welcome you, sir.
We now request our chief guest to address the gathering.
அனைவருக்கும் அன்பான பணிவான மாலை வணக்கத்தை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கின்றேன். Most respected and dynamic dean of this prestigious medical college, the institution is under growth path under his dynamic leadership. It has got lot of plans which is coming up. Dr. Sankaranarayanan, Dean, most respected Professor Jayachandran, retired professor, another iconic doctor. That is what everybody's opinion is. And respected Dr. Arivadagan, medical superintendent, respected Dr. Chandra, vice principal, respected Dr. Pugalendi, respected Dr. Batmanavan, respected Dr. Kadir, and senior professors, doctors, staff members, and other persons who are working in these institutions, and the budding doctors, about 100 in number, the junior medicos of this institute, and the dear parents and dear children. Once again, a very good evening to one and all. I am an odd man out, I know that, because the galaxy of doctors, I am the only person who is not a doctor. This was reflected during the welcome address also. Madam was trying to address me as General Superintendent Medical. Though I am a Chief General Manager HR, she is mistook it as a General Superintendent Medical. So really I feel humbled and honored to stand before the galaxy of senior doctors who are preserving and protecting the humanity in so many ways. Today around 100 of you are going to be graduated from your internship. The transmission of your life journey, of your career from caterpillar to butterfly, you are going to start going to fly. But every one of you is wearing a white gown, but underneath your gown there are differences. There are different passions, there are different aspirations, there are different level of your achievements and different level of your expectations. But one thing is very clear, all my previous speakers spoke that you are all going to strive for your excellence in the career you have chosen. But as soon as I remember, when I remember the concept of excellence, I always remember a beautiful quotation from Martin Luther King, which says, which I'll read, if a man is called to be a street sweeper, he should sweep streets even as Michelangelo painted, or Beethoven composed music, or Shakespeare wrote poetry. You must be knowing the proficiency of Shakespeare and Beethoven and also the Michelangelo. They are legend in their respective field. So a street sweeper is compared with all these legends. And one more sentence is there, very important sentence. He should sweep the street so well that all host of heaven and earth pass to say, here lives a great sweeper who did his job well. So entire heaven and people, the host, they should be surprised about his performance as a sweeper who did his job so well. That is a compliment. So that equally applicable to doctors, engineers, or any profession. Whoever is doing the profession well, whoever is able to do his job well, only is going to be called a person who can excel in their profession. So who can do a job well? Again, there is a principle called KSA, your knowledge, skill and attitude. Knowledge is your what you are learning from your institution, what you are reading day in, day out. And the skill part, the seniors you are imparting to you, your own ability to pick up the skills which is important to you. And third dimension is the attitude. Attitude play a very, very important role in making a person, because beyond a certain level, this knowledge and your skill will not work. If I take an example from cricket field, if you just ask a very great player or good player, always they will tell that beyond certain limit, attitude is very important, because the patience he show at the pitch to face the ball, the temperament he show at the pitch to face a difficult situation only makes the difference. Otherwise, everybody is talented. A person who is playing for a country, equally they are talented, but only thing is the attitude makes the difference. That makes the difference between Tendulkar and others. So the attitude which makes the difference. I have recently read one book written by T.V. Rao. You must have heard, he's an IIM professor and he's a very renowned HRD consultant globally. He wrote a book in which he has divided the people, the professionals, into three major categories. The first category he defines are those who are effective people. The second category, very effective people, and third are highly effective people. Whom he considers as effective people are any doctor or any lawyer or any professional who is able to deliver, applying his skill, what he has learned, without compromising the values and ethics, is an effective person. Also, he touches the life of others. So most of the doctors sitting here, you are going to be doctor from tomorrow. You are going to touch the life of people in some form or other. You are going to apply your knowledge. So you are going to affect the life of, so you are going to be an effective person, but at individual level. There are second category of people whom he refers in the book are called very effective people. Very effective people goes beyond the call of duty. As a doctor, you can always sit in the room, in the dispensary, in the hospital, and when the patient comes, you can treat. You are an expert doctor, very renowned doctor, but somebody going beyond the call of duty, beyond their responsibility, goes and reach masses, hundreds and hundreds of people, thousands and thousands of people. I can quote n number of doctors in the field of who has gone beyond their call duty. One iconic example I can show, you must have read in books, some of your senior professors would have taught you in the class also, is one ophthalmologist from Karnataka who is a Padma Shri and Padma Vibhushan. His name is Dr. Modi. He has, from 1945 onwards, his only mission was that he wanted to reach maximum people possible and give the treatment. What he did from 1945 onwards, he started going for village camps. And he died in 2005. Within a period of 50 years, he has treated Can you imagine the figure? Can anyone imagine the figure? Almost 10 million people. It is 1 crore people he have treated, and almost he conducted 7.58 lakh cataract surgeries with no funding. He is not so rich. He is dependent on the philanthropist and the voluntary organizations, and whoever is donating money, with using that money, he has treated 10 million people and 7.8 lakh cataract operation he has performed. And he has so, his hands are so, it is called almost God's hand. He could operate simultaneously 4 people in an operation theater. In an hour, he can operate perform surgery for 40 people. This is the second category of people which is referred in the book. The third category of people, one step ahead. Those people who are try to institutionalize their vision, their talents and their experience. These people goes beyond their, as a doctor, as a talented specialist, they try to impart their, pass on the knowledge to the another team of doctors, build their own institutions, and that institution will serve the overall community, and that will transcend the life, even after the life of the doctor or any professional, it will continue to serve the society. The third category of people, I can quote the example of again, an institution which was world-renowned. Again, I am referring to ophthalmology because for a better comparison, I am taking that department. It is Aravind Hospital. Dr. What is his name? He is Dr. V. He is called Veda. Dr. Venkatasamy, he is a Stanley graduated medical student, and he joined the Madurai Medical College, and in the year 1976, after his retirement, he has started a small clinic with 11 bed. And in that 11 bed, to establish that hospital, he was not having enough money. So he influenced and persuaded his relatives to pledge the jewels and the properties, and started an institution with 11 bedded hospital, with 6 bed is reserved for poor people. So out of 11, his formula is very clear. Those who can afford, they have to pay. Those who cannot afford, it is free. So 50% of the bed is reserved for the people who can afford to pay, and 50% of the bed is reserved for people who cannot pay. And today, if you compare, it is one of the world's largest eye care institutions with a multi-network hospital. There are training institute, there are research institute, and there are thousands and thousands of people are working. And if you know the figure, again I'm quoting a figure, they have treated 3.8 crore people till now. And I think almost they have performed some lakhs of surgery, cataract surgery again, in the total hospital. So these institutions will, even if the doctor, he would have, whether he alive or not, but the institution will carry his mission throughout the lifetime. So why I am quoting this three type of people is, definitely you are here, you are going to be a specialist one day or other, and you are going to be become an expert in some field or other, then you become an icon in some field or other, again you become a legend. So the possibilities are innumerable before you. Some of you may institutionalize your service, some of you may go beyond your duty, some of you may continue to be affected, because all cannot go and reach the top. So I don't want to take much of your time, but I request all of you, appeal to all of you to carry some philosophy, imbibe some philosophy in your mind, so that your journey will be a smooth journey for your excellence. Number one philosophy will be, you expect more from yourself. When you expect from the institute, when you expect something from the professors, when you expect something from your family, hereafter make it a point to expect more from you. How can you have more from you? Go on update, constantly update what is happening around. go the extra mile, deliver more than what you promise. Have a clear vision. That second one, second philosophy you must keep in your mind is never compromise on your values and ethics. Of course, I can tell very easily, we are going to be working in a government sector. You may think that there will be pressures and influence, but do anything, everything, but you are succumbed to pressure also. It is there, it is bound to be there. But at any point of time, your consciousness should not prick you. You do anything, because as long as you are not committing the mistake as an individual, you are free from that pricking. Number three, always you take your success as your motivation or stepping point. Never allow it to feed into your ego. Most of the good people, very talented people, are suffering because of this. The whole problem is the moment success comes to them, the ego goes up. When the ego goes up, their performance will come down, arrogance will start. So never allow the success to feed your ego, and never allow the failure to make the failure to as a learning lesson. It's a stepping stone. Never be bogged down by the failure. And finally, try to work hard. There is no compromise on shortcuts. So these are all the five principles. If you keep in your mind, definitely the possibilities, the avenues, the excellence, the journey is going to be very comfortable, very smooth, and you will someday or other, you will definitely reach new heights. And with this, before I leave the podium, I must congratulate each and every one of you here for organizing such a function in such a grand manner, that too in a standard, no, it is almost like an award ceremony. I was not expecting that when I came here, but it is like a very professional and meticulous way of planning and execution. And also I compliment for each and every one of you, those who involved for starting this alumni, because the alumni is going to be the any institution. If you take any institution in the country, whether IIMs or IITs or any medical institution, the kind of network you are going to have through alumni is going to be a very supporting factor for your performance, and that is going to help in a big way. So it is better late than never that you have started. Try to give more impetus to the alumni. Alumni network is going to help you very much. And once again, it is my privilege, it is my honor for inviting me to this excellent gathering consisting of excellent people. So before I part, I would like to tell you one thing. Everybody should aim. If you cannot fly, you try to fly. If you cannot fly, you try to run. If you cannot run, you try to walk. If you cannot walk, you try to crawl. But we must keep in mind that always we should be on the move. With this, once again, thanking you all. Wish you a very happy, very promising career in your journey from today. Once again, thanking you, the Dean and the office bearers of this function and the team of doctors here for inviting me. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Respected dignitaries, on the dais, off the dais, my dear colleagues, dear students and their parents, good evening all of you. I am what I am because of him. And as a student, I am very much proud to introduce our beloved Professor Dr. K. Jayachandran, former professor retired from Stanley Medical College. He is well known for his professional supremacy, sincerity, commitment, humanity, and ethical practice, leadership, and extraordinary teaching capabilities, simplicity, and finally for his non-compromised patient care. He graduated from Madras Medical College undergraduation and MS in 1971. So got married in 1971 to Dr. Patmini, pathologist. She was also our teacher. Later he completed his pediatric surgery in Pet Hospital College, 1980. Then he served in Chengalpet Medical College, Tirunelveli. Again he came back to Chengalpet, and finally to Stanley Medical College in 1998, got retired. So after the retirement, so he was starting his servicing hospital, Smart Mini Health Center at a hill place, Tenganikottai. It's 20 kilometers from Hosur. From there, we had to go uphill. The roads are not that much been built in those days in 2000. It would be very difficult to reach. And patients also, they find it very difficult to come for the health sector facilities. So that is why he decided to go and do the service there. So in Chengalpet Hospital, he is the one who created the Department of Pediatric Surgery. He always comes in white, just reflecting his heart. Everybody can just feel, oh, so that doctor, he always comes in white with that black shoes, always. It's a trademark of his dressing. And he is the one who made me as an anesthetist when I was an house surgeon, 1 week posting. So it is, he'll give ketamine. He'll tell, you are the anesthetist. I'm going to do the IND for this. In his OP, he'll do it. So he is one of the, everybody knows him only as a pediatric surgeon, but I know him, his anesthetic capabilities. And after having known such a enormous talent of an anesthetic capability in a surgeon, that's why I've been like an anesthetist now. So this hospital he was running almost from 2000. Along with his wife is also, after some time, she also joined. And then almost they are doing a 200 to 220 cases per year. Almost bi-monthly, 6 camps will be done, including all faculties. ENT, ophthal, gynecological surgeries, general surgeries, the latest lab surgeries, urology surgeries. The surgeries you cannot imagine that can be done in even a multi-specialty hospital. That will be done here with the most talented and experienced surgeons with enormous capabilities. And all the patients will be pre-screened by him, and post-operative care will be taken by him. He is like a person leading an army. And he trained all those people in and around those help areas, the students, everybody. They teach the knowledge for to take care of the post-operative care and everything. It plays the best of them. And then never compromising the quality, even in that thing, for no cost to the patient, it will be done. So for almost from 2000, he is doing it. So I welcome our beloved Professor Dr. K. Jayasundaran, MSM Chase, to deliver the convocation address now. Thank you, sir.
Honored Chief Guest, Mr. Satish Babu, your beloved and now my beloved Dean Dr. Sankaranarayanan, Vice Principal Dr. Chandra, your previous Dean Dr. Muniyappan, and the learned professors and other dignitaries, your dear parents, and also the, I'm trying to get your batch name. Can you do it for me? Zenforianz. Good. You're born to heal. But now you're born to hear. Because so many people have already taken the time. And I'm not going to leave you so early. So, this is such a privilege for me to be here, most unexpected. And you already have a most unexpected person here. I have no friends in a Facebook. I'm not so witted to be followed in a Twitter. literally, I have no awards also, but a literally nobody. Maybe I thought your dean and the others would have decided, as you are now dreaming amongst yourself, will I be somebody someday? Yes, even if you are a nobody, there will be somebody and someone to make you somebody, and you will be called address even greater gatherings. With that hope, you can start and you can listen now. And another thing I was just thinking is, it is almost my 60th year of entering my graduate course, and now we are almost exiting it. This privilege of being in this profession, with this vast gap of 60 years between you and me right now, you can always feel the older people have a tendency of glorifying their days. Not your grandparents, your parents, and you're going to do it with your juniors. Oh, golden and how greater were our days. The prices were lower, the currency was stronger, the environment was greener, and the music was softer, the youth were still kinder, so on and so forth. And that is why the Beatles once sang, I believe in yesterday, I believe in yesterday, yesterday all my troubles were away. But the times change. We have all come into the fast instant stage. And so this is another poet who said, now the reason said, come on, kick off your shoes, turn off the lights, hold me tight, love me straight, and it'll all be over night. Just we will be out of sight. This is the present day. Actually, this is the world you are now going to enter into. And there was an young gentleman who's just graduated and got a promised car, and he just wanted to go for the nearby shop, but his dad said, son, the shop is so near, why do you think God has given you two legs? And sharp came the reply from the one, he said, daddy, one for the accelerator and another for the clutch. And said, son, go ahead in your life, but do not forget the brake. You need the brake more often than you need your accelerators and your clutches. And you are also entering into the fast world. At this time, there is a tendency always to not only get things speeded up, but also cut short the roots. Someone asked, where is the shortest way to the hospital? And some smart guy replied, stand in the middle of the road, you need not move, you will be moved. One or two will be after you. And so, but take this lesson one, a mere acceleration and failing to steer carefully with a controlled steering, you may end up in disaster. And then the shortest routes, you may always not be the best route, because you may miss life's best scenarios and also very good lessons. So take the best route possible that was advised by your seniors and your parents. And now, can we just switch over down the memory lane for some time? You all dreamt of coming into this place, getting into the medical education, I don't think it would have been a child's play. You would have spent a lot of time, especially with your parents, the midnight teas, maybe dad waking up with alarms, and so on and so forth. It can never be that. What got you here? I'll tell you in one word, that you were true to yourself. You, if you had cheated on your parents, if you had cheated on your own self, I don't think you would have made it. Yes, you wanted to do it. There was a passion and there was a pain. But you focused on the purpose and the pain became nothing, as you are now with all smiles. You are ready to go. But this is just one phase. But what you are now going to enter may not be the same. There may be a lot of things, because in the present world, just as we say in the olden times, the physicians were intensively working without incentives. The surgeons were passionately cutting without cutbacks. There were no scams of scans. But all with this you are now entering into. But still, that one thing will definitely hold true and hold you too. Hold to the truth. Do not cheat yourself, neither cheat anybody else, and this will take you a long way. See, it is said, the truth is always on the scaffold, the wrong forever on the throne. But see, the scaffolds will surely sway the future, because behind the dim unknown standeth God watching his own. Behind the dim unknown standeth God watching his own. See, just you may not believe whether how can I survive in this world with excessive commercialization? What can we ever do to gain some prominence? Again, I promise you, just as I see enter into this campus, one year, a truthful service, everybody said Dr. Sankar Narayanan has changed this, because he was true to himself and he believed that the people will all be true to him. So this is what exactly happens when you really do not cheat on yourself. What do I mean by cheat on yourself? You know, first, the golf player, you know, the Tiger Woods, he was caught in a scam. He was just asked, how is it? It was such a popular, famous guy as you could get into these things. What got you into this? He simply said, I lied to myself first before I lied to the people. So before, it's the first thing happens is lying within ourselves. Okay, this is just a small thing. We can compromise and get on. This will be forgotten. This will be covered up. Definitely that will have its repercussions very much later. And that's one small incident. Again, I'll tell you, there was one guy, his boss asked him, when a phone call came, he was just telling him, come on, tell that guy that I am not here. Tell that guy that I am not here. He refused to do that. Say, I am the boss here. You just got to tell him that I am not here. Then he just covered the phone and talked to the boss. Sir, you are asking me to lie for you today. It won't be long before I start lying to you. I just don't want to start it. So this truth will ever be your guard and your shield and what you're going to start is said as a race and people call it a rat race. If it is going to be a rat race, you just got to be sure, even at the end of the race, what are you going to be? Still a rat. So you're not going anywhere. So once, if it is a race and you want to run fast and you want to run ahead, problems do come. Go back to the stage you started preparing for this. The love of your parents and the family members surrounded you. The grace of God was showered on you. There was everyone pushing you, supporting you, and you need it even now. As you take this race, do not try to run ahead, but run along. That will be a pleasant thing to take your professional colleagues along with this. The professional dignity starts with treating your colleagues with dignity. So run along with somebody. There is no competition ever should be involved. It is only a companionship. This companion, when you run the race with this companionship, it will take you for a longer distance with ease. And so with this, I would just like to give a last anecdote and finish. We have enough knowledge, but we know we need wisdom. Some SKA, you said, knowledge and skills, yes. But still, what is the difference between the skill and the knowledge? It was about Sherlock Holmes and Watson. Just maybe in an area, in a knitting camp, they had their tents on. And in the middle of the night, Sherlock Holmes nudged Watson and asked him, "Hey Watson, what is it you see?" He said, "Millions of stars." And he asked him, "What does it tell you?" "Astronomically, there are billions and galaxies and etc., etc." Astrologically or astronomically, again, that Saturn is in Leo. Chronologically, it may be 3:30. Meteorologically, tomorrow it may be a good weather. Theologically, oh, what a wonderful universe, galaxies, and how insignificant we are. And suddenly he asked Sherlock Holmes, "Holmes, what do you think?" He said, "Watson, you idiot, somebody has stolen our tent." So, in the night, it is just so simple a thing. But we are lured with so many things. And the truth is the casualty. Every media, everywhere, to whom we can ever believe, whom we can place our trust on, this continues. And most of the times you may have the Radio Ceylon's old time song that may be reflecting in your mind right now. When the soul is darkened by a fear that is unknown, and the rules do not fit the game, who will answer? Who will answer? And we can be boldly saying, the truth will always be your answer. And this race, there is no finishing line. When you go along with that, you can go beyond, as he said. Your Indian Medical Associations, and especially the people, Dr. Padmanabhan and so many, Dr. Giridharan should have been here as a pediatric surgeon before he, and also Dr. Arasu and his daughter Ramya should be here somewhere sitting, I don't know. But still, they are the people who created something that they say that I am doing now, I am not doing. They have something called a reverse medical tourism, where they tour to heal a patient, where the doctors themselves pay for the patient, and the students they were once have become teachers. They are teaching me now, and they are making me something. So it all can happen when we hold on to the trust and truth. Congratulations once again. God bless you. Thank you.